is your playground. Abstergo.
Hello, Initiate. Recently, Abstergo Historical Research began several new projects in London. We both know that when Abstergo makes big moves, the Templars are up to something. We think they're hot on the trail of a new piece of Eden. I've got people in London looking for it.
Hey, Bishop! Jacob and Evie Fry are twins. How awesome is that?
Speak of the devil. Fire up your cameras, Beck. I've got picture. ETA on the payload.
Sending it now.
A lot to sift through. I'm gonna get the initiates on it ASAP.
You look weird with a weapon. Let's plant a little bug and see what we can see. Got something. Isabel Ardant has a meeting here in a few hours. Doesn't say with who.
Doesn't say with whom, Rebecca. I suppose it's down to Muggins here to find out.
Hold on. The mission was to find data to locate a piece of Eden in London.
We did.
And now, I am eager to try this new kit.
I don't like it when those two go off book like this. Well, all we can do is take a deep breath and move forward. You'll be searching for the piece of Eden through the lives of Jacob and Evie Fry, twin assassins who operated in Victorian London. Your first set of genetic memories are downloaded. Good luck.
Brother George, it is as I feared. London has fallen. Thrice I have written to you begging your aid. Thrice you've responded with silence. And yet I write again. So desperate my need, so few my options. I need you. London needs you. You would say it is too great of a task, or that it is not yet time to strike. Patience, you would counsel. But whilst you wait, the Templars consolidate their power. They have chosen a Grand Master so ruthless, so thorough, one might think Reginald Birch himself had returned. His name is Crawford Starrick, and he intends to rule the world. There is no aspect of society he does not control, no industry that escapes his grim touch. By day, it is corrupt merchants and venal politicians who hold court. Come night, a vicious street gang known as the Blighters strikes terror in the hearts of all. There is no business untainted by his poison, no person unexploited, be it by duplicity or force. Our enemy has designs on the highest office of them all. And so, as you look inward, and dare I say it, afraid, Crawford Starrick's ambition is fixed on the beyond, to kingdoms and continents as yet unconquered, though not for long, for he knows. As I have warned you time and time again, whosoever controls London controls the world.
The iron ship's from here. The Templar running things is Rupert Ferris and our target one. Target two is Sir David Brewster, who's got his hands on a bauble that could ruin us in this wretched war. Think you both can handle it?
What a question.
All right. My mistake. Ladies and gentlemen, the unstoppable Fry twins. See them nightly at Covent Garden.
George, honestly, I've studied the plans of the laboratory and have every route covered.
And I've got all I need. Right here. I'll extend your regards to Ferris.
Chat later, George. We've a train to catch.
Jacob! Evie! May the creed guide you, you vagrants!
Poor man, more afraid than ever. Years have not been kind.
Evie Fry, where do you get it from?
The same place as you, Jacob.
Have fun.
Don't die.
Like this. It's disrupting the other workers. Shut his trap and get the machine fixed. And send me some laudanum for my head.
Coming right up.
Locked.
What do you think you're doing?
Stop now! Before there's trouble!
No one goes in or out, unless there's a problem.
I hold the machines. That door opens, and I have my route to Ferris. Sanitary inspector. This man is dead.
You're the dead man!
Run along, Elm.
I'll teach you how to beg for mercy.
You're moving at one pace!
Drink!
Time to head for higher ground.
Visitor! Stop it!
get to work! Your families are counting on you!
Mr. Ferris, sir. The lad in the factory should be taken to be bandaged by the apothecary.
Fine. But dock his wages.
Yes, sir.
Shall we arrive at a final price, Mr. Ferris?
Generate a steady profit for many a year to come and provide the raw material to build several new trains. I expect a knighthood for this. No, don't bite.
It is done.
Oh? What did you accomplish, boy? A bolt loosened in Starek's machine. A large bolt, but not enough.
Your Grandmaster will fall.
You assassins can circle London to your heart's content. The mechanism we have built has been going strong for 100 years and will run 1,000 more. It is the very city itself.
We will take London from your hands.
From Croydon? You lurk in the shadows like a coward. I doubt it.
Assassin, kill him! careful, boys!
We seem to have made an unscheduled stop. Maybe next time I'll walk.
Yard. Guard quarters. Brewster's laboratory. This is where the Peace of Eden will be located. No loose ends. Now, did a couple the locomotive and create a diversion.
Well, where is it? Huh? Where's Brewster's supplies? Meter.
Time to deploy the diversion. I'm on my way, Sir David.
different tune to run through if you have to.
Like Jacob's cooking. That should keep you busy while I head into your lab.
Me down the tracks.
You stay here and keep a lookout.
All right. I'll shout if I get any bother.
First for a bird's eye view. Can't be too careful.
Alec, I'm apart.
Not your concern. Bring back the cargo.
I need 2 more weeks with the device.
Your questionable practices are beginning to draw unwanted attention. You have been given more than enough time to achieve results, Sir David.
I was unaware that you expected me to perform like a cocker spaniel.
Permit me to remind you of your obligation to the Order.
Miss Thorne, you ride me like a racehorse.
Sir David, I will return tomorrow. If you have not unlocked the device's secrets, forget your dogs and horses. I will leave you to the wolves. Good day.
I was merely promised a tour of the premises, my lords.
Who sent you?
One of Green spies.
Get that man to interrogation. Then I want him brought to the lab.
What a pity. But no deviations from the mission.
I love the sound.
Dead meat!
I'm waiting
till I get hold of you.
Come back here! Shit, she's getting away!
It's all right!
Nearly there. Is Brewster's laboratory. All reconnaissance pointed straight here.
Neither green nor black.
Some woman, nor brown.
Henry Green!
Ah, thank you kindly. I was in ever such a squeaky fix when, what do you know? You rescue me.
Where's the hidden laboratory?
Untie me and then we can parley, m'lady.
I'm pressed for time. Tell me now.
It's underground. Requires a key. One of the guards nicked mine, cheeky sod.
Thank you.
Now untie me?
You got yourself in. I trust you can get yourself out again.
Not to worry, m'lady. Can still recall a couple of tricks from me carnival days.
Charming.
Downstairs, then. I want to see that artifact.
Not if you value your life.
Hey, leave them rats alone. They've as much right to be here as you.
Mind your own post. I'll feed them to me cat.
Poor little rats.
Oh. She's an intruder!
Ah!
What's Sir David up to in there?
Don't know and don't care to ask. Because at night, the grates glow with an unearthly light, as if the dead are climbing up out of Elliot's cell.
Margaret the poet. What else?
Ain't nothing else. And you should keep to your work. Sometimes, they're screaming.
Really?
Mind your own business and get back to work.
What could that be?
There you are. The entrance to Bruce's lab. Thank you.
So do as you're bloody told. And by the way, it's sir to you.
The blokes are knackered, sir. Someone's gonna get hurt if you push too hard. Honest to God.
And someone's gonna be out of work if you keep on whinging like your old codger.
Of Eden.
Increase the electricity.
But it'll become unstable, sir.
You heard what Miss Thorne said. We need results now. I will win this war, Miss Thorne.
There's a trap! Ah!
Soon they will be free of this god forsaken authority. A little more electricity! Stop there! It must be kept stable!
Time to lay down your head, Sir David Brewster.
But I have so much more to discover.
Do not be afraid.
I'm not. God will protect me.
I will continue your experiment.
You will not stop, Starik. Miss Thorne has already found another piece of Eden, more powerful than the last.
I will take that one too.
We fight to gain what we cannot take with us. It's in our nature.
Was there explosion?
What explosion?
Evie?
Piece of Eden detonated and took the lab with it.
The magic lump of hyperbolic metal. I'm shocked.
Simply because you have never valued the pieces does not
all
mean...
went according to plan,
There was a slight complication.
How slight?
The lab exploded.
Jacob!
You derailed a train.
Oh, he did. Did he?
Well, the train derailed and I happened to be on it. I killed my target.
Brewster is also no more.
Then all in all, a successful mission in spite of you two.
What about London?
What about it?
We're wasting our time out here.
You know as well as I do that London has been the domain of the Templars for the last 100 years. They are far too strong yet. Patience.
But the Templars have found a new piece of Eden.
Sir David is dead. They do not know how to use it. The Council shall guide us. Sound advice that your father would have seconded. I shall see you back in Crawley.
Patience, Evie.
Ah, oh, the gentle sound of opportunity passing us by.
So what's stopping us? London is waiting to be liberated. Forget Crawley.
Father would have wanted us to listen.
Oh, Father, you could continue his legacy in London.
Freeing future generations from a city ruled by Templars. You know, Jacob Fry, you might just be right.
Then shall we?
Yes. Let's. Onward to London.
Check in on Sean and Rebecca. I still think attacking a Templar is a mistake.
Call Dr. Grammatica.
Oh, come on. Oh, Isabel, what a lovely surprise.
Our mutual friends will be here shortly to search for the artifact. Once it's located, I'll let you know.
Super. Always a pleasure.
Prick.
It's people like you that give historians a bad name.
I'm afraid I don't have time for you today, Mr. Hastings.
Thank you for making my job easy.
Oh, shit.
It does look grim.
Master Berg, Agent Acosta. Deal with them, please.
Move it! Hunt them down!